Hello, I'm Dr. James Freeman from FixHepC, and today I'm here in Egypt with Dr. Shireen Helmy from European Egyptian Pharmaceutical Industry. Shireen, I hear there's quite a lot going on with Hep C generics in Egypt.
Yes, luckily Egypt in 2 years was transformed from the highest burden worldwide with Hep C infection to be the first country to treat all waiting list patients, which is more than 1 million patients. So if we cured in the past 2 years, 1.5 million worldwide, out of which 1 million from Egypt and more than 600,000 from Farco.
So can you tell me how Farco became involved in making these generic medications?
It started with a meeting years ago with Raymond Chinazi, the one who worked in Pharmaset and discovered Sovaldi. And he came to a trip to Egypt with some visitors and friends whom they asked that we work together in producing something new for virus C other than Sovaldi. And he asked us to build an API factory because the cost of the API is so high. I remember the first quotation we got for sofosbuvir was $1 million per kg. Now it's coming less than 2,000 with very high, good quality. So what we did is we checked how can we start this, and we had some Italian friends whom they made the design for a API factory in Alexandria. And also during that time we checked whether Sovaldi is patented in Egypt or not, and we found that the patent was rejected because of the dates of applications and so on. So the product was not patented yet, the process and the polymorph might be still pending. So we also got another consultant to produce sofosbuvir with a non-proprietary process or non-infringement process, and also with a new polymorph shape, so we would not be infringing any of the patents. And starting from then, we started some sort of collaboration with the Saudi company for API production till our factory now is ready and we're producing our sofosbuvir here. So generally speaking, we found it very challenging to find a solution, because if you don't look, you won't see. And the prices of medicine nowadays are very unaffordable. So we thought, how can we go with patent laws and at the same time solve the problem of people? So to pee or not to pee, that's the question. To patent or not to patent. In the United Nations Secretary General High Level Panel for Access to Medicine, last March or the March before in Johannesburg, South Africa, 100 participants, each were pulling in a side. You have activists, you have US government representative, WTO, WHO. Everybody was looking for his side. So I started with, to pee or not to pee, that's the question. To patent or not to patent. Life gains versus trade gains. And how can we go with the law and at the same time find solutions for people worldwide to get affordable medicine, especially for non-communicable diseases or long-term chronic diseases like hypertension, diabetes, and so on. So we thought of making a teamwork, and that's why we started with Drugs for Neglected Diseases Initiative, DNDI, working together in Malaysia, Thailand, South Africa, in finding a pan-genotypic solution for Hep C worldwide. And we're now conducting some clinical trials in the Far East. Also, we're interacting with the medicines patent pool, I think by the EASL, on the 20th of April this month, we're going to announce in a press release Farco joining the medicines patent pool in licensing out its Revidevir produced by or innovated by Presidio San Francisco to people so that they can get it affordably.
So with generics, one of the big questions that comes up is, how do I know that I'm getting the same thing? Can you tell me more about that?
You know, in pharmaceuticals, there's lots of research, development, and many things that assures the company first that this drug is bioequivalent or according to standards, and if the patient uses it, he will get the good effect. Second is the patient makes sure that this medicine, which was released by the quality control or the quality assurance department of this company, has the same medicine which is sent to you. So you have to make sure of the authenticity, and the company has to make sure that its product is bioavailable and a quality product.
So can you tell me about how you actually go about that bioequivalence testing?
Yes, sure. For us to apply for pre-qualification for WHO, which we did a couple of years ago, we had to make bioequivalence, and the product was bioequivalent, and also the center was audited by WHO and approved, so the center of bioequivalence, to make sure that the study was accepted. So all this is in the process. We did not have the pre-qualification yet, but we're waiting for the audit on the 8th of May for our finished dosage factory, and the 2nd of May this year for the API factory. So we're in the process. So having a pre-qualified product also would give trust to patients worldwide, but we have to have it first, then we can claim that we have it.
So do you see HCV generics following a similar course to what we saw with HIV generics, where we've now got half the world on treatment?
A year and a half ago, Stephen Victor, he was responsible of HIV, HCV in WHO, he said what Farco is doing for HCV reminds me what Cipla did in 1995 for HIV. So I see lots of hope for patients, as we are planning in Egypt to have Egypt almost free from Hep C on 2020, Africa 2025, and the world 2030. I think before this we can do it, because our Ravidasvir now is being in clinical trials, multi-center, multi-countries. It's going, inshallah, to show good results together with other helps. So I think there is lots of hope for patients, because every 45 seconds we lose one person in this world. 700,000 deaths a year from Hep C. So every 45 seconds you lose one person, which we should save. We can think of some sort of a fund or something to help others for not being affordable. So we'll make it happen. If there is a will, there is a way. Thank you very much.
Fantastic. Thank you.